Callan Diggs here, and in this video I want to talk about another nomadic lifestyle that is also popular and will continue to be in the future decades, and that is traveling the country in a RV, travel trailer, or even van. Now this is quite becoming a thing. You know, you may see people, they call doing the van life. They may live in a van, which probably gives them the most flexibility because they can stealth camp. You know, they can park in neighborhoods, they can park in parking lots. You know, if their windows are tinted and, you know, they put measures in place to give themselves privacy, to the average person, average spectator, they can look like just a normal vehicle, you know, but a person can actually be living in it. A van gives the person the most stealth, you know, as long as it doesn't have things on top of it, as long as it doesn't appear that they're living in it. Most vans give the nomad the most stealth. Now, you do have things like a travel trailer, RVs, but you don't have any stuff with that, you know? So kind of how it works is, if you want to travel, let's say you want to travel to the U.S., you know, let's say you want to do that for, I don't know, 2 years, 3 years, maybe longer than that, a van will give you the most stealth to do that, you know? You can't, you know, doing it with an RV or travel trailer and trying to park in cities, that's not going to work. You know, you're going to get hassled by code enforcement or police. That's not going to work. But with a van, be that, again, the van gives you the most stealth. It gives you the ability to, like I said, live in multiple cities. You just have to find good places to stealth camp. Now, if you have an RV or if you have a travel trailer, you know, a person still can be able to see many parts of the country. Especially in the U.S., there's something called National Forest or BLM land, which is the Bureau of Land Management, which gives the person the ability to stay there for 14 days at a time. Now, most of this free land is kind of out in the West, but you can find some in the East as well. You know, and you know, worst come to worst, you rent an RV park, you know, you get like maybe a month, you know, a subscription, and you can be among nature. That could be a very fulfilling way to travel, you know, especially if you really appreciate nature. You know, some people, you know, they may like it for a day and they get bored after a while. You have to be a certain person for it. So, you know, if you're really into it, this is something that probably you will really enjoy. And, you know, there's so many sites to see, so much BLM land, so much national forest land that you can explore, and it gives you that ability to live nomadically. And you can sustain yourself if you have a source of online income. It's harder to do, if your job is local, it's going to be harder. But if your employer allows you to work remotely, that gives you flexibility as well. With seasonal jobs, you can actually do it as well. You know, instead of living in their accommodations, you can live in your RV or travel trailer or van. And but the only problem with that is, you kind of have to commit to that certain time frame. So if they ask you to stay there if they ask you to commit to 3 months, then you're going to have to be there for 3 months, unfortunately. So that's something to keep in mind. But if you really enjoy the area, you know, then it can definitely be worthwhile. Typically, it's just common upon a lot of seniors, like a lot of people who are retired, they'll kind of go in an RV and kind of travel the country and kind of do that for, who knows, almost the rest of their lives. But like I said, the van life type of movement has become more increasingly popular. It's not for everybody, but it does give you an opportunity to see outside of your city, see outside of your state, to be able to see different parts of the country. And wherever country you are, there's so much beauty in it, and I would advise you to take the opportunity to explore. You only get one life to live, so why not live fully now? It's my intention for you to reach the finish line, and you can start by going to reachingthefinishline.com. And until next time, I hope you're reaching your finish line.